Jayden, just kind of take us through this day. Oh, by the way, my name's Callie.
Nice to meet you, Callie.
Oh, yeah, if you can do name and affiliation so you can kind of get some names and faces.
Sorry, it feels like I didn't know you. Just kind of take us through this day. What have you gotten to do? Is this your first time in Dallas? You know, how are you taking this all in?
Yeah, I mean, it's been super fun. This is not my first time in Dallas. I've been here a couple of times, but like this is my first time like actually like being able like to come to like the facilities and like meet everyone. So it's been going good, just like to come here and meet everyone, like, and like it's been fun. So yeah.
How have you kind of processed, and who have you gotten to meet so far, and just kind of taking this experience for the first time?
Yeah, I'm still like processing it all. Like it's still hitting me. Like, but I'm just super excited to be a Maverick, and I met with the head coach, Jason Kidd, Nico, and a bunch of the other staff, other coaches. So they're all here, like they say, they're here for me, and they just want to see me succeed. So can't wait to get to work.
Dwayne Price, Mavs.com. Jayden, what do you feel you can help this team get to the NBA Finals next season?
Yeah, I feel like, I mean, with my game, I bring a lot of stuff. I feel like I bring three-level scoring, my ability to play, make, create for others. Getting my teammates involved, and then I know here is going to start on the defensive end. That's how I'm going to gain the coach's trust. So just being a better defender and really just being able to learn from the vets and the players that's already on the team.
The Mavericks saw you dropping in the draft. They got back in the draft just so they can get a hold to you. What does that mean to you? They feel like they feel that way about you?
I mean, it just means a lot. I feel like they like really like want to see me succeed, and I feel like, I mean, I'm super glad that they got me.
Brian Marantis with Sports Illustrated. You said you were super excited to learn from some of the veterans. What do you hope to learn from Luka Doncic?
What I hope to learn from Luka, I haven't met him yet, so I'm looking forward to meeting him, and then just being able to like talk basketball with him and talk about his journey and really just like picking up on new things from him. And like it's like he's going into his couple of years in the league, so just being able to ask him questions and like really like how he got to where he is now. So.
Is there anybody currently in the league that you really studied?
There's a bunch of players that I love to watch. Like, I really love to watch Luka. Like, I love his game. I like Bradley Beal's game, James Harden, Damian Lillard. Those just to name a few. But, I mean, I like watching a bunch of players. So.
What have you envisioned about your possible fit with Luka and getting to play with him?
I feel like, I mean, just, like, coming in, just doing whatever the team needs. I feel like I'm capable of. And just, like, with all the tools that I have to my game, just me, like, being able to shoot, and me being able to create, I feel like I could fit with this team really well.
Kevin Gray, 105 through the Fan. Jayden, how would you describe your game as a player and why you would fit, not just with this team, but how you fit in this league?
Yeah, I would describe my game as really, like, different. Like, just me being a three-level scorer, like my ability to knock down shots from deep at a high rate. And I feel like just me being able to create for my teammates, I love playmaking. And just like being a defender, and I feel like just with all those tools, like I could fit really well with this team. I feel like I'm gonna be able to fit well in with the guys, like being able to meet with them, and like I feel like I'm bringing a lot of energy. I'm bringing young energy. I'm super excited to be here. So,
what would be the biggest improvement that you want to make in your game as you start to get acclimated to the league?
I'd say the biggest improvement that I want to make to my game is just being an efficient player at this level. And just improving my defense and just really being able to learn and be consistent.
Newy Scruggs, NBC5 here. Question for you in terms of the draft. Before the draft, there were a lot of talk about you possibly being a top 10, top 15 pick. You had to wait in the room. Now that it's over, do you feel a little disappointment? Are you carrying that with you as you go forward here, or do you just let it go?
It's always going to be with me, like, just like, because I was like the last one, but it just added more fuel to my. It just added me like motivation, made me want to work harder. And I'm super excited to be a Maverick. So I'm glad they got me. And, I mean, I just can't wait to work. So.
Jayden, this is Tim Cato with The Athletic. I know you haven't met Luka, but I think you did meet at least Christian Wood. I saw some videos of you guys playing pickup or something.
Christian Wood, like I've been knowing Christian Wood for a couple of years now, so that's my guy. And like with him like being like having his Vegas roots, like playing at UNLV, like we already knew each other. So yeah, we didn't play in a couple of runs with each other like a couple years ago, so he already know who I am, and I feel like we got a good relationship. So,
good timing for you to get here right when he gets here.
What do you think he brings to this team?
I feel like Christian brings versatility. I mean, I feel like his ability to be an outside shooter, his ability to like be a pick and roll threat, catch lobs, stuff like that. And then on the defensive side, he loves to compete. And I know he's going to come in every day and try to get better. So,
what's that going to be like for you going back to Vegas in a couple of weeks in the summer league to play in there for the Mavericks?
Yeah, that's going to be super exciting going there. Being playing as a Dallas Maverick is something that I always dreamed of, like being able to go play in summer league. So just going back and being able to play like in front of like my second hometown is going to be fun. So
you were one of the top recruits in the nation. How close were you to going to college as opposed to going to the G League last year?
It was just more so like the fit that I wanted, like with college and pro. I felt like I was ready to be a pro, and I feel like that decision, I would make that same decision if I had to choose it again today, just because me playing against NBA level talent, and I feel like it's going to help me better in the long run.
What is your biggest inspiration? Dorothy's entry on Messenger Media. What is your biggest inspiration?
My biggest inspiration, I would say, is my family, just like coming from where we come from. And I feel like just the position I am I'm in today, it's like it's a blessing from God. So my family is a big inspiration to me. They always supported me in whatever I do. So.
Valencia King with Real Talk Sports. Dallas Mavericks are really big on community, so a couple of questions so the fans can get to know you. Mm-hmm. Do you have a favorite movie?
A favorite movie? I don't have a favorite movie, but I do like action movies.
Okay.
Yeah, I like action movies. Yeah.
And then do you have a favorite childhood cereal that you ate growing up?
That's his favorite childhood cereal.
That you ate growing up.
I used to like Cinnamon Toast Crunch.
Yeah. Hey, Jalen, Landon Thomas, Mavs fans for life. What's one skill set that you have, that you possess, that can help you immediately make an impact in this league?
I feel like my ability to shoot the ball, I feel like that translates right on. Like just me being able to come in and be an outside shooter, feel like that take pressure off of Luka when teams are focused in on him, like me being able to knock down those outside shots.
What were those conversations like when you just met with Miko and Jason?
It was a great conversation. They just sat me down, like focused on like what I need to get better at, how they see me fitting in with this team, and really just going from there. Like, and then just looking at summer league and how they envision me being there.
What's your takeaway about what do you think they're like personality wise?
I feel like they're very cool. Like they're very open minded. Like they. Like, wasn't sugarcoating with me, like, anything. So I could feel like I could talk to him on a personal way, so.
For those Mav fans that haven't seen your game through the G League, is there a particular NBA player, past or present, that your game models or is similar to?
People used to compare me to, like, Bradley Beal and, like, Dame and, like, James. But those are just comparisons. I feel like my game is just, I feel like I got my own way of playing. I got my own style, so. I just can't wait to get out there on the court and compete against those guys and show them, like, who I am.
Your game a little bit better than those guys.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
What did you learn about being a pro in the G League that will help you in your transition now to playing with the Mavericks and being in the NBA?
What I learned in the G League is just really, like, how to be a pro, taking care of my body, just from building good habits, like staying after practice, like getting those extra reps, being in the weight room every day. And, I mean, it just taught me how to be a pro and, like, what it takes to be successful at this level.
When you go against some of your friends and guys you play with now, because you're in the G League, do you notice you may have a little edge on them because you played in the pros versus what they may have done in college?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Playing in the G League, that's NBA-level talent. Like, I played against guys, like in this year in the G League, I was able to play against, like, Jonathan Kuminga and Moses Moody, who was just on the Warriors. So, like, playing against, like, those NBA-level talent guys who were just on the championship team, like, it's only going to make me better. And I feel like playing that NBA level competition, like it shows you like what you need to get better at, and coming into this next season, like I feel like I got a chip on my shoulder. So.
Thank you.